Hello, everybody. Sift here again with another Nordic Ashes run. And today I'm going to be doing a run with Axel Door and the Hammer. And let's go into Midgard on normal hard mode because I haven't beaten it yet. And yeah, let's get to it and hope for the best. Now, specifically, today's plan is to, you know, get both upgrades on the axe. We already got our free first relic. Let's actually start leveling up here instead of waiting like a stupid guy. Let's level up the brand, the boot. And you know what? I want to actually expand into this as fast as possible. The Fury, more damage for every time you get hit. So we definitely want to instantly try to open that path up, and we're gonna also get one more level into this area damage, whatever it is, what it is. We didn't get anything out of that. This is a relic. What does this relic do? Flint, a burned enemy has a 25% chance of burning another nearby enemy. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. So I guess we're gonna be a burn build or a fire build or whatever. So yeah, let's maybe go full on into fire build, although I'm pretty sure enemies will not be burning twice, right? So it doesn't even make sense to go into a flame build or a double triple flame build, because the hammer actually has a flame version as one of its legendaries. And of course, I went ahead and I already pre-unlocked the second legendary, so I can, you know, double down on the legendary we're gonna go with. So yeah, I do know for a fact that the hammer has a fire legendary as one of the two. When I say legendary, I mean, you know, the ascension or evolution, or I think it's called ascension in this game. So yeah, one of the ascension levels of it is going to be fire, and we're going to get both of the ascension levels. So we don't need to invest further into this. How many levels do I have? 3, nice. Let's invest into the moose. So every time I get hit, I increase my damage forever. So now we're going to start abusing those potions that drop from the boxes as we're doing the classic box loop. As we're trying to, know, you know, go into loops and try to find the boxes in the same spots again and again. In case you don't know, that's a thing in this game that you do. You can loop around a specific area in the map, and the boxes are always going to be in the same area, therefore providing you with a bunch of potions and items and coins and pretty much everything that you need for the shopping phase and also the run itself in general. Like, doing a box loop is definitely a good thing in this game, or at least that's what I believe. Of course, it might look boring, but I mean, there is the boring way and then there is the winning way. And those two are the same. let's actually go into this to pick up the relic here. We're very close already, like 24 kills isn't anything. And look at this, we just got a big potion, so now I got hit on purpose. So I can take the potion and actually just use the potion as if it's a damage multiplier, instead of just leaving it there on the ground and being like, okay, we got that potion for later. I don't need the potion later, I want damage right now. So let's start leveling these up. Area damage, cooldown duration, nice. Duration, by the way, means it flies farther away. Projectile, I'm gonna take it, but projectiles is bad in this item. You're gonna see in a moment. Like, imagine how you think projectiles is gonna look like, and you're gonna understand when you're gonna see now what it actually looks like, why it's bad. Look at this, boom, boom, it shoots twice. Disappointing, am I right? Like, wouldn't it be more cool if it shoot out like 5, 6, 7 at the same time? I think it would be really good. Now, I'm not gonna spoil later that this, you're gonna see how this is gonna go. It's not really the end of the world that it doesn't do that, because there is a fix to that. Yeah, still, I mean, it's a bit disappointing. Let's continue with cooldown duration, honestly. Area and duration. I mean, do I even need area? I'm not really sure. Do I need this thing to be huge? This is my epic upgrade, and the thing is, it's level 9. It's like, we have two upgrades left, okay? We have the epic and rare upgrade, and then the double legendary. So I think I don't want to throw away my epic onto the area effect. Yeah, still no. I'm okay with this, though. I'm okay with the cooldown getting the effects. And then the next level is going to be damage and cooldown, I would say. Or damage and projectiles. Yeah, then I'm not okay with this. Yeah, I don't want area, man. I hate area. I'm maybe okay with this. Yeah, because... No, duration is good old... Maybe I'm okay with this. I mean, I don't know, man. I don't know. And I even lost my boxes because of all this train of thoughts. Hey, look at this. This is like, I have never seen this. This might be a million coins. For all I know, this might really be a million coins. So, who knows? Let's get a box. We got hit on purpose, I will say, to get damage. Damage up, cooldown up, projectiles up. I can get projectiles from here, and then I won't care about the rest. I think I'm gonna get projectiles from here and not care about the rest. So what do I have right now on this? Cooldown duration. Might as well go for cooldown duration, whatever. And then the next level up, we're gonna go with... I hate the duration too, though. Like, look at this. It's already... Duration is how far it goes. And as you can see, it already goes pretty far. It's not like huge. It doesn't cover the whole map. But it is already okay. And if I start investing into passive levels, then it's gonna become even further out, right? So there isn't really any real reason to go for this. So let's roll this. This is a yes, though. Cooldown, and this is definite yes. Two more projectiles and a bit of cooldown. It's gonna start throwing out like 3, 4, 5. And then the last level is going to be, in my opinion, cooldown. Damage and cooldown is, in my opinion, the last level. And now if I'm gonna actually invest damage in cooldown, we're gonna see, but I think damage is a guaranteed actually. I don't think it's guaranteed that I'm gonna go for damage for the legendary upgrade, but for the cooldown, depends on what we roll. Which, by the way, the chances of you getting the upgrade you want is, let's say you say two things, right? I want damage and cooldown. So, first of all, we're going here and see how many are the choices. One, two, only the lit up are the choices. One, two, three, four, five. So you want two of those five. So it's a 2 out of 5 to get one of them, right? It's 2 out of 5 chance that you get one of those two that you want. And then after you got that, after you already got one of the two that you want, then there are only 4 other choices left. So it, and you want one of them, so it's 1 out of 4. So it's 2 out of 5, and then you multiply that with 1 out of 4. So that is the chance of you getting exactly what you want, which is a pretty decent chance, because 2 out of 5 times 1 out of 5 is 2 out of... why do I do slow math? 2 out of 20, which is 1 out of 10. So you have a 10% chance to roll exactly the skills that you want, which is really good. Like, 10% chance is good. Area and duration, definitely not. This is also no. Now we're gonna go for the 10%, by the way. Now the time has come to go for that 10% that I literally mentioned exactly right now. So let's just hope that we're gonna find it, because if we don't find it, we're gonna just start spending coins in this. And the average levels of coins you can spend is, you know, 10. Theoretically, you know, you should level, you should have 10 levels, and then those 10 levels should be rerolls. I mean, let's go. Nope. Ah, should I invest into projectiles maybe instead of cooldown? How much is the cooldown? 1.6. You know what? Let's invest projectiles, whatever. I just threw away 2 or 3 levels by doing that, what I just did. But I think I should not go into sunken cost fallacy. I shouldn't say, like, you know what? I already spent like 3 levels. Now I'm going to spend another 10 on top of it. No, we're just going to not do that. Is this 50 coins? It is 50 coins. So what a crazy artifact. 50 coins right away. This just made the game, by the way. Unless we die from the first boss we're going to fight, which is a very good chance, because, you know, there are things like, I don't know, losing. It's a thing. People do that. So you never know if we're gonna, you know, actually survive this run. I mean, I'm gonna be honest here. If this video exists, then I will survive this run, because I'm not gonna upload a video where I literally die within 10 minutes. That's like factual, okay? Sometimes we have to look at the things factually, and I am a content creator. So factually speaking, I mean, it's very obvious that I'm not gonna upload something I am not feeling okay with uploading. And uploading a 5-minute loss, definitely not part of it. Now, if you think others don't do that, rethink. And change your opinion maybe to others don't upload them either. Just saying. I'm not saying, like, losses in general. I'm not talking about, you know, a 40-minute run that at the end is a loss. I mean, that's okay. But uploading something that's literally, you know, you start the run and 5 minutes later you're dead. I mean, I think everybody understands what I'm saying, right? I mean, it's very obvious. I am pulling the curtain here on what is real and what maybe I should say or not. Like, oh no, Sift, you're not supposed to expose the fact that not everything is real. I know, but maybe that's a thing, but I don't care, man. I'm just saying my thoughts over here, expressing my opinions with you guys, and I hope you guys agree, disagree, comment down below, etc., etc. And I hope you guys just enjoy the content. That's what I care the most about. We avoid doing some loops, so I keep them in the fire. That's the plan. Now, I'm thinking about doing also, alongside the hammer build, I'm also thinking about doing the... what is it called? I'm also thinking about doing a good old electricity item, because the electricity item is supposedly... I mean, no, what am I saying? I'm thinking about going with electricity alongside the fire, because I do not know if I have the second ascension of the electricity unlocked. And also, why would I go double fire? Why would I go trail fire path alongside fire hammer? As that would just burn the opponents twice. I mean, I think I already mentioned this at the beginning of the video. The moment we got the flint. Yeah, I think the moment we got the flint, I was talking about what this build is going to be. Whoopsie! Whoopsie! Let's burn down these boxes. Nice, we got even more money. I'm a bit sad that I haven't found a magnet. That's what I'm trying to find right now. Which, the chances of that actually happening is whatever the game decides to do. So, oh, 2 potions. Very nice. This is the attack speed effect, right? Because purple is attack speed, I'm gonna take this YOLO. We're taking all of these all the time, every time. It is the attack speed, as always, so that's actually good for us. We want to fall. Whoa. Getting hit by elites is definitely not okay for us. And let's level this up. And let's also send it right away. So I got Shockwave. Each attack throws 3 Shockwaves, or each attack leaves a trail of fire. I'm gonna go with Shockwave so we have better coverage. And I think I'm gonna, first of all, invest into attack speed. I'm gonna invest in one level into this. Actually, no. We're not gonna invest into anything else, because if in any case I find like a box or something, I want to have the ability to be able to just straight up say, okay, we got a box. It's gonna give us for the hammer. Like, I want to upgrade the hammer with any upgrade that possibly might happen here. Okay, I don't see us getting the magnet in time, exactly. So that room is dead. Let's get another ascension crystal and another 5 coins. And let's ascend this twice. And now we got burning trail too, so now it's shooting out fire alongside everything else. Potion, not really a thing I want to take. Oh, I get a blue heart every time I enter this realm. Okay, let's get armor, archery. I don't want this. I don't want the taunt. Whatever. Give me magnet. Nice, we got the magnet. This is probably the last one, max life, which I'm gonna take. This is another weapon. I'm just gonna take any weapon we find. We want to just do a bunch of damage all over the place, because why not? Whoa, this is money is power, which, and it also gives you 5 coins, so this just costs 5. And this is another bow. We're gonna continue with the bows. Roll for another 5. 20 coins in the bag, I can buy both of them. Movement speeds for sure. And when I'm low life, I do a lot more damage. You know what, I'm gonna take this too. But say, if you got money is power, doesn't matter. 10% power against, you know, 35% power when I'm low life. 35% damage when I'm low life, 20% movement speed, 1% damage for every gold I own up to 99, because, okay. that was me, by the way, being like triggered. Add 1 full heart container. Attack speed's good, 50 gold, 1 damage, and the stats on the flames. And we also got 8 levels, so I think I want to invest into a bunch of stats. Right, I think I want to go damage, attack speed, blah, blah, blah. So let's for sure go this, and let's start investing into cooldown, I would say, first. Because I already get the potion for crazy attack speed. Yeah, I mean, look how awesome this looks. I did unlock both of them, but I have not seen how the flame looked. Like, the flame looks insane. I did know that the triple path exists, and that's what I tried to, you know, sideways explain at some point, that yes, it's really, really bad that the projectiles are made like this, but at the same time, it also doesn't really matter, because, like, when the more projectiles, it was sad when I first saw it, because, you know, I wanted to be like, 5 projectiles mean 5 fly out at the same time, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter, because, you know, there is the triple upgrade anyway. So, yeah, I guess there's that. You know what would be better? It would be better if the Ascension said each projectile amount also makes it... What is this? This is so bad for us. Okay, theoretically, what I want to do is go in there, in the spikes there. And, yeah, I want to go in the spikes over there and pick that relic up. But the thing is, you know, the potions are over here and... Okay, I have a plan. And that plan is called... Keep the blue potions. You know what? Forget the blue potions. I'm gonna do something extremely stupid and everybody's gonna cringe with me, but I don't care. So I'm gonna start getting hit here. Ooh, we got a magnet. Yeah, let's definitely get hit. Get hit again. Come on, get hit again. Nice. First of all, I'm thinking about using this magnet. No, I'm gonna leave this magnet here, actually. I don't need to use it. Okay, let's get the magnets out of the way. Let's go over here. We're gonna boost our damage through the roof. You guys have no idea. I'm gonna go in here. I'm gonna like boom, pick this up. That's even more damage. Get hit again. Boom, pick that up too. We're scaling damage, Ryan. What does this do? 1 damage and 10% attack speed, which is a lot, which is really good. Here, we're gonna get hit twice again. Hit me. Hit me, anything, anybody. Come on. Okay, machine gun of death is firing off here. Get hit once. Get hit twice. Thrice. I want to get hit a bunch of times. Get hit. Come on, more. I want to get hit, like, full down to 0 life is what I want to go with. Because the idea is, I'm going to pick up the potions here. So, let's pick this up. Let's get hit again. Come on, I want to pick up the blue potion is the thing. There are, like, red potions over there that's going to heal us anyway. Get hit. Come on. I'm going to be low life. I want to get the 35% damage. Like, that's the idea. Okay, now I'm still alive. Heal again, plus 1. Please hit me 1 more time. And 1 more. Come on. Okay, no. And now we lose. Now I'm gonna lose the most powerful one I ever had. I'm gonna literally lose it by mistakes. So, okay, now I got, as you see, 1 potion in the back. Right? And now we're gonna start drinking and finding potions and healing. I mean, theoretically, I just want to pop them open and have them on the map. And then just run away and pick them up later. Like, theoretically, that's the plan, but practically speaking, that's most likely not gonna happen. And, yeah, I mean, here we are. This is where I want to do the fight with the boss and everything else. So, the moment the boss hits me, I just drink that potion over there and we're good. Then there is another potion up here, we're still good. We're even better, to be honest. Yeah, now I'm just gonna loop around and break a bunch of boxes, hoping that they're gonna have money and some potions. And then in the boss fight, I'm just gonna loop around, pick up all the potions, and just fight. Or I cannot risk this. Okay, the plan is done. The plan is over. Now we just actually want to heal. Yeah, I'm not gonna do this whole plan without having actually, health. So, yeah, now the plan's out the window. Like, the idea was everything was based on me having a blue heart. Now that I don't have a blue heart, it's just useless. And there is a very, very, very clean explanation of why that is. And the answer is because bosses do one damage to us. So, a full heart, that is. So, if a boss decides to just destroy me, it hits me while I have one heart, I'm just dead. Nice, we've got a bunch of levels, 14 levels to be precise. And now we're gonna go into a bunch of passives, I would say. Maybe also go into ultimate, because ultimate's really good. I'm gonna go ultimate. Do I even care about the ultimate? I don't really care about the ultimate. Just go with this. Let's go with the crazy not projectile speed. No. Let's go with damage. Maybe even movement speed, attack speed. Let's fly the things out faster. Okay, I'm gonna leave the last point for later. Let's go with fire damage too. Actually, fire damage might be more important than everything else that I tried to gain. Up, let's continue destroying. I really enjoy that we have a magnet, and then we have another magnet. I feel like I'm about to get lost. Which might very well be the case. Nope, the super potion's here, and then the magnet's over there too. Nice. So we're good. Oh, even more boxes. I just realized I have the flying sword things. The flying arrows, not flying swords. Let's continue firing off into the sunset. And not a single one flew off to the left. Like, are you serious mode? Let's continue. We got the magnet, as we said. Just go on looping the boxes. Now we're in gathering mode. So I think in this game you're going through some specific modes. There is another magnet, that's unbelievable. I wanted a magnet in the previous map, and on this map the game was like, oh, you want the magnet? I hear you wanted magnet. Like, didn't you say something like that? Didn't you say you wanted a magnet or something? And it's like, okay, take 50. But I wanted one. No. It's either 50 or nothing. Choose. I guess 50. Hey, in the middle of there, thing dropped. Wow, unbelievable. Oh, we found another potion. Let's get it on purpose. Nice. Continue increasing my damage exponentially and more and more and more. The more damage we do, the better, of course. And we also, not only do we do crazy damage, come on, machine gun these guys down. But we also gain a bunch of XP because of all these flames spreading out and just destroying everything. I'm so sad that the elites don't mostly drop boxes. Like, most of the time they drop big XP pots. I would have enjoyed it a lot more if they dropped big boxes. I cannot lie. Whoop, I like big boxes, I don't lie. Whoop, avoid the hit. Nice, I think movement speed is the play at this point. Like, this elite is definitely very much, you need movement speed oriented. And I'm gonna definitely make sure that this magnet here is not gonna get lost. So, let's maybe avoid. I saw that I lost a coin down there in the corner at some point. But it's okay. I saw there was also meta progression currency. Nice. Let's avoid the boss, by the way. I don't want the boss to get hit me. I want there anything else to hit me other than the boss. Because the boss does avoid full health of damage. Now, that's pretty much the only reason, by the way. If the boss didn't do a full health of damage, I wouldn't care. And we just lost a health for no reason. Let's loop around. I saw the potion over there. I have to run to the magnet. Pick it up. Avoid the boss. I'm gonna run towards the potion. The boss is dead already. I'm not gonna be fast enough. It is what it is. It is what it is. Didn't really lose anything. 66 coins. There is a health potion over here. Do I need it? Not really. Can I take it? Yes. Blue. Is blue crits? I don't know what blue is. I'm gonna take it. Yolet. I hope it's damage. It's not gonna be damage. Cool, Tonic. Cooldown 30%. Lose attack speed, though. I'm okay with it. Now that I got another crystal, the time has come to invest into this, because I'm pretty sure. I'm not exactly 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure I haven't found this ascension level ever. So let's go with whatever. I don't want effect probability, but I don't care. Okay, damage and cooldown, nice. Area, yeah, whatever, damage, cooldown. Yeah, can I get a bounce? I guess not. I don't want effect probability. I just don't. Yes. And this is going to be a forced bounce damage. Or damage cooldown. No, damage is guaranteed here. It's either bounce damage or damage cooldown. No other choice. Nope. Okay, damage cooldown it is. And ascension. No! Oh, I didn't get the crystal. I was like, no, it doesn't exist. No, it does exist. And I actually had not unlocked it, so nice. We unlocked it today. Paralyzed enemies by this relic explode when dying 3 more beams. Okay. I do not really want the plushie. I still don't enjoy it. I do want the potion, but I will take it last and if I want to. Hey, Gnonky. This is XP gathering. This is a bunch of stats. A bunch of stats is a yes. Yggdrasil leaves. Oh, Gnonky's level 3. I love you, Gnonky. I don't even... I want to see what Gnonky level 3 provides you with. Yes, we got magnet range. Let's go. This... isn't this like a super shield that explodes when you get hit? Isn't this something extremely... Yes! Yes! Where's the shield? Where is the shield? Wait a minute. I can go down there with the mouse... Okay, I'm going down with my arrow keys. So yeah, 36% cool, 36 second cooldown, absorbs one hit of any amount of damage and explodes, pushing back all enemies, doing 75 damage to all of them. This is lightning all around us or something. You know what? Instead of taking this, which electrifies opponents close to us, I'm gonna re-roll and choose one of the other two relics that are gonna appear. Yeah, this is everything around us moves slower. I have found this. Yeah, let's take it. Everything around us moves slower because why not? No. That's not what it does. I'm so stupid. This does creates an area around you that freezes your enemies. Every 0.61, whoever gets in has a 50% chance to just get frozen. So that's what that does. And yeah, I think we're ready. Yeah, do you see this? Do you see like the push? That's how whenever the effect happens. And if somebody happens to be in there the moment the effect hits, it does what it does. Let's get the 3 coins. Gnonky continues leveling up. I love you, man. I love Gnonky. He's awesome. And let's continue. Now, is there anything on the map left? I don't think so. I will sacrifice the blue heart for... Yeah, for all of the rest of the things that are around us here. Mainly, the main focus being that, you know, health. There is a bunch of health around us. Get hit. I don't know if the elites, by the way, do some more damage to us. I'm not sure. I don't think they do. Burned. Let's heal. Now the plan is to just amass money. In case you don't remember, just saying, money is power. We do have that. So we definitely want to invest into money. Every single coin of money, a coin is 1% more damage. Now you might say, but Sif, in that vein, you threw away a bunch of money at the shop. Yeah, but money also caps out at 99, so I prefer throwing out money for stats and weapons and whatnot over keeping them. By the way, if I get hit by the shield... No, so if I get hit by the shield, I do not get the damage boost. Very sad. Let's get the movement speed here. Let's get hit on purpose, as always. Let's continue scaling our damage and everything else. What a nice machine gunnery. What a nice build here that we have going. I really enjoy the power we have. And because I have the magnet, I'm not even afraid about, you know, doing whatever I decide to do. So, oh no, I got hit. Who cares? Hey, look at this. We take 50% more damage. We do 50% more damage, but we take half a heart of damage. I don't really want this because right now the final boss is gonna kill us in 3 hits. If I take that thing, first of all, I will easily die from everything here. And secondly, the final boss is gonna kill us in 3 hits instead of 4. 3 hits instead of 4. Plus the shields. I want that, actually. Yeah, I want that. But I will lose 15 coins. So that's, in reality, it's 35% more damage for if we take half a heart more. So it might not be that safe. It might not be that safe, to be completely honest with you guys. Oh, we got another damage boost over here. So let's go and drink that potion. Come on, hit me, please. Ooh, I feel like the elite's coming in. Boom. I got hit. Let's continue. Hey, look, it's an elite. Hey, look, it was an elite. Now it's dead. Now it isn't anything anymore. I don't see the electricity explosion damage thingy happening. I mean, just because I don't see it happening doesn't mean that it's not happening. I'm just saying that there isn't any crazy animation. I heard the sound effect that I think I heard for the first time. I heard like a whoosh, which, I mean, I didn't really replicate the sound effects well. It was like a vase or something. Like, it was like... I don't know, that's what it reminded me of. Some kind of vase getting flung. Now, something I realized is that when elites appear, less opponents spawn. Although, that doesn't really mean anything right this specific moment, as we're about to go to the final boss. So, at that point, like, all of these are gone. I have 9 points. Let's start investing into passives. Do I want projectile speed? Not really. I want damage. Let's go with damage. 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 And damage. To burn damage. Very nice. And I'm gonna say movement speed. I want to get as much movement speed as possible. Yes, I know the other choices are like... Wait, have I gotten the cooldown? I'm missing the attack speed, but honestly, I want movement speed, man. I want to have the ability to avoid hits, especially in the final fight. So, let's just hope that we're gonna get enough levels here. Today, I didn't get a single chest. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe I listened to a chest sound. Maybe that was the thing, the whoosh effect that I listened to at some point. Maybe, just maybe, I missed a chest somewhere. I don't know, man. Let's avoid what we can. I got another level, another 2 points, actually, not a level, 2 levels. Oh, we found a potion. Let's get hit. Let's get it again. Oh, that was a mistake, by the way. What did I do? Why did I get hit twice there? I should have just drunk the XP gain and then keep the potion for the final boss fight. That was definitely a mistake. Like, definitely mistake. Oh, there is a big potion in the corner. Hit it once. Get it twice. And before the boss appears and stuns us. The boss is here. We're gonna get stunned now. Boom. Pick up all the XP. Level up, level up, level up, level up, and we're still leveling up, still leveling up, still leveling up. 16, so, oh! And 70 levels. So, I can either invest 2 levels into this, because this costs 5 and 7, plus some rerolls, or I can go for the movement speed, which I think we're gonna go for the movement speed. Like, that's my idea. Wait a minute, this is 5 plus C. This is 5 plus 7. I'm gonna buy this guaranteed, because... Now the choices are either I go 3 plus 3, that's 6 points, and then another 5 on the ultimate. Or I can just do a bunch into damage. I think I want the ultimate, man. The ultimate in general is decent. Cooldown duration, this is a trash roll. I'm gonna go with 10% movement speed. I cannot get this anymore, so with 5 points, I'm gonna buy the attack speed. And we're gonna also buy as much damage as we can, which is 1 point. And now we're gonna run fast! Oh, we got hit for 10 damage. Okay, he attacked us. I mean, we are doing a lot of damage to this guy. Oh, that was the shield appearing, by the way. I'm really bad at avoiding. Something isn't going well, like me avoiding. Come on, stop giving me that attack. Oh, the blade. Okay, I think we got this. Okay, once again, the blade. He is evolving. Yep, he is in the I don't get damaged phase. Which, yeah, really enjoyable as always, but, I mean, it is what it is. You just do loops. I'm just waiting for my shield to appear, like his shield, right? Can I please get the shield to appear? Can I please, like, get it? Okay, move downwards! Nice, I got the shield, so we got our health here to tank. Wow, my, we're Shindaru! Avoid. Flash, slash, got him. Easy dodges. Move upwards. I'm waiting for the ultimate chance for the ultimate, by the way. Which maybe I shouldn't do that. Oh my, Shindaru, he's off-screening. Continue with my Magma Hammers. Slashes, I can't even see him with all this redness that's happening. Okay, let's ultimate him in. Wanna get ultimated? Get ultimated. I YOLO'd there! I YOLO'd heavily! Avoid everything! God's exploded. I mean, we should get him mostly. Why doesn't he just blink anymore? Where did the Omae Shindaru go? He's down. We won. Now 2 leaves. RIP! Conqueror Midgard in hard mode have with Axel Door and extra beams. Use electricity, explosion, ascension. The extra beam thing. Extra beam thing. Okay. So our DPS was... Okay, my ultimate had 527 DPS. So I remember when we had an ultimate that had 200 DPS and I was like, the ultimates do 200 DPS, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I just realized something. Like, all the things I have, my stats, my damage, my relics... Those things do affect my DPS. So, an assumption I did about how much damage the ultimate did and whatnot is pretty much thrown out the window, to be real. And this, you know what? Actually, if the ultimate, I can use the ultimate level 1 to understand how much damage my main weapon did. Because if my ultimate level 1 did 527 DPS, while I have had ultimate, yeah, this, okay, let me actually go from start to finish. So right now my ultimate had 527 DPS, and my Iron Hammer, my main weapon that I upgraded as much as I could, as best as I could actually, got 790 DPS, as best as I could based on my decisions, right? And this thing here, Thunder Armor, did 3d1, so this is complete trash as a weapon. I think it's complete trash, unless Iron Hammer was the main reason why this did no DPS. But the main thing I want to mention here is that we have had a run where The Infinite War, a Whirlwind, did 200 damage, 200 DPS, and the iron, my main weapon used to be, I think, the sword or something else, and that thing did 800. So by using the ultimate as a rating, if we did a lot of DPS, right? If the ultimate did 500 DPS, then my main weapon should have been doing 1000 plus, right? If my level 1 ultimate does 200 DPS, then my main weapon has to do like 700, 800, somewhere around there. So by having an ultimate doing 500 and my main weapon doing 8 instead of 1000 plus, it means that this was complete trash. That's my opinion. I might be wrong about this. The hammer might be the most powerful item in the game. I mean, I don't know. Maybe somebody down below is gonna comment and tell me like, yo, Sift, you're wrong about a lot of things, but this thing, you're especially wrong. I mean, you can tell me whatever you want. 10% chance to find extra gold, especially with the looping thing. This is going to be like, I don't know, instead of 150 coins, it's going to be 165 coins, because that's what 10% of 150 is. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, drop a like, subscribe to the channel. If you want to see more, subscribe too. Don't forget that. I really enjoy this game. It's just a chill vibes game. I really enjoy how we're slowly scaling. I really enjoy how Gnonki is making the shop better. Like, I really enjoy everything that I have seen up to this point, and all these skills are just so simple and clean, but also at the same time awesome looking. It isn't full on screen covering, it's just like three paths of flame going around, so it's just so cool. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. I'm excited, I guess, today. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, I'm glad. So thanks for watching, and see you guys around.